And on the show, a big story. India has sent dossier after dossier that contains incriminating evidence against 2611 mastermind and his handlers, Hafiz Saeed. But Pakistan has till date been in denial. Therefore, in what comes as a very curious development there, a top mantri in the Nawaz Sharif government has finally conceded that Hafiz Saeed is a terrorist, is a threat to the internal security of Pakistan. Lashkar-e-Toyba chief is a UN-designated global terrorist, but till now, Pakistan has always provided Hafiz Saeed the status of a social worker. But Pakistan Defense Minister Khwaja Asfis has now branded Sharif as a social stigma and called him a threat to Pakistani society. But can Islamabad, that continues to torpedo the 2611 trial, for instance, in which Hafiz Saeed is wanted by India, take pride in sheltering Masood Azhar and patronize Lakhvi and other co-conspirators who continually target Indian strategic assets? Is Pakistan trying to fool India and mislead the world? Reactions coming in on this story. Obviously, the government is circumspect because it says that Pakistan might now have changed its mind, calling this social worker a social stigma, but it needs to do a lot more to prove its bona fides. Here are those reactions coming in on it.
Hafiz Saeed is a terrorist. It's not a secret. If it has taken Pakistan so much time to realize that, well, then it speaks volumes about Pakistan not willing to see the truth as the truth was. But whether they will still take action, to what extent they will take action, that is to be seen. India's stand has been consistent. It is for Pakistan to understand that globally there is a concern that terrorists can have a safe haven within Pakistan. They can move freely, they can move fearlessly, and Hafiz Saeed was no exception.
Classical duplicity of Pakistan. The entire world knows that Pakistan is a state that produces, nurtures, harbors and exports terrorism, not only to India but to other neighboring countries like Afghanistan. But Pakistan must realize, when you are going to harbor snakes in your backyard, sooner or later they will bite you. We saw the gruesome murder of school children in Pakistan. We also saw the recent blast where civilians, innocent civilians, lost their lives on account of terrorism. Who are these organizations? These are the organizations whose benefactors is ISI, Pakistan Army and Pakistan establishment. So just detaining people like Maulana Masood Azhar and others in an air-conditioned five-star premises will not do. If Pakistan is sincere, then Modi government should push Pakistan for handing over Maulana Masood Azhar, Lakhvi, Daud Ibrahim and other terrorists to India so that they can be prosecuted for the terror crimes they have committed. Only then Pakistan can make a small beginning towards fighting terrorism.
Okay, India is taking this very, very suspiciously. Major General G.D. Bakshi, defense analyst with us this evening. Also from Pakistan, Lieutenant Colonel Shafkat Saeed, defense analyst. Shafkat Saeed, you suddenly have designated Hafiz Saeed from a social worker to a social stigma. Your defense minister now calls him a threat to the Pakistani state. Your reaction to that, Shafkat Saeed, Lieutenant Colonel?
In a way, he has become, his existence is now disputed by United States, and on your behest, on your pressure, United States is towing your line, and he has become, in a way, a sort of threat to Pakistan, yes?
He's become a threat to Pakistan in what sense? Your minister says,
yes,
that
because of his
this
being
gentleman,
there, you are the whole world.
No, you're being creatively interpretative. You're being creatively interpretative, Shafkat Saeed. You're trying to suggest to me that Pakistan actually views him as a threat because India and America is going to go in there and bomb you out and lift him out of his little cubbyhole that he finds himself in. Remember, he's kept in great comfort. He's kept in great comfort, Shafkat Saeed, in a nice plush home under house arrest. General G.D. Bakshi,
I can't hear anything.
Pakistan, one second. Pakistan, General G.D. Bakshi, Pakistan comes out and says that, look, this is a threat perception we are feeling because America has been convinced by India to go in there and take him out. That's why we feel he's a threat.
Look, the simple fact of the matter is, Rahul, that the Pakistani deep state, the ISI military complex, has got a very well choreographed SOP of what to do whenever they are under, you know, the global public pressure or the global pressure for taking action against terrorists. The choreographed steps of this charade are that they first try and put the so-called Hafiz Saeed or his cohorts under house arrest. If that doesn't work, then the next step is they will even put him behind the bars like they had done it for Zakiur Rahman Lakhvi. And he had, as you know, fathered a child in the Kot Lakhpat jail, and he had established a command post, a five-star command post in the prison. And the moment the pressure abated, well, the Pakistani court set him free. Because they felt there was not a shred of evidence against him. This whole charade, this whole hoax routine, this sham will be repeated again, I'm very sure. Right now, they are quite worried that the, you know, Donald Trump is walking the talk and he is going to put pressure. He will not take it.
Hafiz is an anti-social element, says their defense minister. Such people are constant threats to Pakistan's sovereignty. This is an indictment of Hafiz Saeed. Shafkat, I want to ask you, Lieutenant Colonel Shafkat, I just want to ask you this very simply. Why don't you hand him over to us if he's such a problem? Give him to us, we'll deal with him. Don't worry. Hand him over to us.
Now, okay. On what do you, how do you qualify to take him over from us? What is your relationship with us? Do you think that if we ask for somebody, you would give him to us? No. We are not having the type of relation in which we can do this exchange. First of all, let's have that relation. What pretext do you have that we can have common interest and common goals?
Who do you have that relationship with?
No, we don't have any. No, we are opponents.
You don't have any relationships.
What do you think that...
You're a pariah state.
What collaboration you are looking
at?
You have
no commitment, no relationship to humanity at all. You don't care about people who actually attack
innocents. What humanity? Humanity only exists in India. It does not exist in Pakistan. What do you think that today eight people have died,
and a
few days back 80 people had died? They are not humanity. Only India is part of humanity.
Absolutely,
and for what
sir,
all you blame,
we are saying that anyone who is killed by the act of terrorism deserves sympathy. What are you saying? We are saying whether it's on your surface or your land or whether it's on the Indian side of the LOC, anyone who's killed at the behest of a terrorist deserves sympathy, and that terrorist needs to be put behind bars. Now, suddenly, Pakistan seems to be making the right noises. We are only asking, sir, why just make noises?
Pakistan
hand him over to us.
Is just
if you're serious.
Wither away the American pressure. It has Hafiz Saeed has nothing to do with terrorism, whatever. Hafiz Saeed, like
so he's a social
every
worker
Pakistani
who is now
Kashmiri
deemed
freedom.
A social stigma.
Every Pakistani
he's got nothing
wants
to
Kashmiri
do.
Freedom, and he's one of us. He's any like okay. Any other Pakistani.
General Bakshi.
And you people go on to say that Mr. Nawaz Sharif dictates from Hafiz Saeed and the Chief of Staff dictates from
Hafiz
Saeed.
Yes, he's delivering
Colonel,
that. He's delivering those individuals in the POK freedom from Pakistan. He's delivering POK, POK Indians freedom from Pakistan also. Don't worry about that. Yes, General Bakshi.
You know, I am slightly surprised that he is countermanding what his defense minister has just said, that Hafiz Saeed, he has stated, whether under American pressure or because of the gravitas of
yes,
the forum that he was just gracing, he has said that Hafiz Saeed is a threat. I'm afraid that's at variance with what you have come out with, that Hafiz Saeed is Mother Teresa reincarnate. I'm afraid it will be very difficult, Colonel, for the world to buy that. We do not see him as a reincarnation of Mother Teresa. He has the blood of hundreds of innocents on his hands. And to call such a man...
But don't be surprised, General Bakshi. Don't be surprised.
General Sahab,
because the gentleman that we are addressing right now
Karkare,
is a former military man.
You know about,
and we also know that Pakistani army has groomed the likes of Hafiz Saeed and several other terrorists as their strategy to bleed India through a thousand cuts, this asymmetrical sort of warfare
that
the Pakistani army has waged. So I'm not surprised at all.
That is not our strategy.
The Lieutenant Colonel Shafkat is got so much sympathy for a global terrorist who his own government today wants in the dock. All we are saying is hand him over.
Why don't you ask for him? Please qualify to take.
We've asked. And for not once, but several times.
Mend yourself. No, with this bossy attitude and trying to become a hegemonic.
So, General Bakshi, this is the point. The point is that the change
to humanity and humility. Only then you can talk like that. And from
calm down, sir, calm down. Don't give us lessons on humanity. Speak to the Baluch people, speak to the people in POK who are being butchered by your army.
Baluch people
then
are very
talk.
Comfortable.
And speak to the minorities in your country, sir.
Whatever
the Shias, the Hindus who are being eviscerated, sir, at the point of a gun by individuals that you harbor like snakes in your backyard. No, one second. No, please don't preach to us about human rights, etc. I'll leave it at this. We'll take a short break.
I don't want to preach.
I'll leave it at this. We'll take a short break. The eyewash is apparent. Individuals like this who belong to the Pakistani deep state are perhaps the ones who are most upset by this move, but they are not going to fade away. They're going to put pressure back on the Pakistani government. In a few days, you will see it'll be all back to business as usual. Short break on India Upfront. We return in just a few moments. Just days after installing her proxy as the new Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, Shashikala Natarajan is plotting her next move. Shashikala's legal team is working on a plan to get her jail swapped. They want Shashikala shifted from Bengaluru's Agrahara prison to Chennai. But experts have warned against the move and said that it's the duty of the Karnataka government to ensure that Shashi remains in Bengaluru. They also added that what is wrong with Bengaluru jails since Shashi has been given enough security already. So the question is, will a transfer to Chennai mean both comfort and control for Shashikala? Is that what she's after? Let's throw this open from the DMK, A. Sarvanand, who is dead against this move, and C. Rajashekaran also joins us, sympathetic to the AIDMK's cause. Mr. Rajashekaran, what's the problem with Bengaluru? Nice city, very nice jail. J. Dalita spent time there. Is that not good enough for Shashikala?
Rahul, see, the Tamil Nadu Prisoners Manual, Rule 780, clearly says that reciprocal transfer of prisoners can be done. It is the rule. It is the prison rule. So, they can transfer the prisoners, whoever they want. It is just an ordinary procedure followed.
Don't throw the rule book
all
at
the
me.
Prisoners.
What is the problem?
Cases.
What is the problem with Shashikala Natarajan serving out a sentence for an act of corruption in Bengaluru? Answer me that question. Don't tell me what the rule book tells me. I also know what the rule book tells me, sir, but this goes beyond rules.
I'm sorry, can I ask you the same question back? What is the problem of same Mrs. Shashikala Natarajan serving her jail tenure in Puzhal prison or Chennai, whichever prison in Tamil Nadu? What is the problem for you, for anybody, for that
what
instance?
Is the problem? DMK,
no,
DMK Sarvanand, would you like to respond?
See,
what's the
jail
problem?
Is a jail.
I'm not raising not the issue. Let's ask the DMK. DMK,
see,
what's the problem, sir?
See, when the rule
see,
is there... When
yeah,
the, when
yeah. The legalities.
There's a rule. They're exercising an option
the
under the rule. What's your problem?
Yeah. Legalities apart. See, it's not only a question of legality. Of course, prison swap could happen, but it's not a question of legality alone. See, the people are already very, very unhappy that proxy CM is ruling the state. At least they have the satisfaction that, you know, the remote control is too long, so that, you know, every issue could not be micromanaged. But if you know, she's going to be transferred to Chennai or somewhere, the prison here, then the interference in the administration is going to be very stark and very direct, which is what the people of Tamil Nadu doesn't want to happen. And that is what we are reflecting.
Okay. Respond, Mr. Rajashekar.
Rahul. See, this is hypothetically on assumption and presumption. DMK wants to score political brownie points, which is not at all fair, because she hasn't interfered, she would neither wish to interfere, and it is too
how can you
too
say she hasn't interfered, sir?
Assassinate somebody.
She has picked an individual to replace
though,
her as chief
course,
minister once
Court
she was told that she can't, no, that she's not eligible because the Supreme Court's ruling came out and struck her bid down. So don't say that she is not interfered. She's definitely interfered. She's orchestrated things. She was there at the resort and trying to quarrel and cobble her government and for her party. So let's not say that she's a bystander innocently watching proceedings. Now she wants to be close so she can consolidate her hold over the party. Let's be honest, she probably also feels that she'll get a greater sympathetic hearing in jail. She'll get plush comforts. Let's not run away from all of that. We have seen what has happened with Shahabuddin in Siwan jail. Because he had people in power who were sympathetic to him, he was getting even massages in jail from what we are being told. So let's not run away from all of this. We know what the game plan is. Now, you can put a spin on it, you can throw the rule book at me, but let's not be upfront. Let's be upfront on this show. Let's not try to spin me. Yeah, come on. Respond, sir. You have a minute.
No. It is... See, you are... I don't know what is the problem for DMK when there is a rule and a law, and what is the problem for anybody to so much bothered and worried about.
So you're going to cling to the rule book to justify what is an apparent bid to relocate for creature comforts and to exercise greater control. It's very interesting. Yes, the DMK cannot object legally because the rule allows it.
That is a perception of...
But sir, politics is also about, politics is also about symbolism, and the symbolism here is very clear. Shashikala Natarajan, feeling insecure, wants to guard her flock, wants to ensure that they all remain true to the oath that they have taken. We leave it at that.